everybody, how are you doing today? Today I want to talk to you about going downhill technique. So I think one of the important things is to know the terrain we are going to do, like to train on and practice on the terrains we want to do, to understand that it's different to have rocks or to have grass, that we will put the feet on a different way in every kind of terrain. For example, here in a technical terrain, we'll do like small steps and to keep the good balance. But I think the most important is visualization, to look where to put the vision when we are going down. And I think it's a bit a difference between like look close, look far, look close, look far. So we will look to the feet if it's very technical, but we need to look like 4-7 steps. Then when we see that, we can find the best route we will go and to imagine every place where we will put the feet. Close and looking far, looking close, looking far. More is technical, more we will look close to our feet, more it's easy, we will look farther. But it's always important to memorize and to have the vision for to know where we'll put the feet for the next 5-7 steps. And also we need to adapt the speed and the length of the steps depending on the terrain. If it's technical, we will do short steps. If it's less technical, we will do longer steps. And we need to use, I think, all the body, like the hands and the arms, for keeping the balance. We need to think that we have a ball in our stomach, and we need to imagine that this ball is our gravity center, so we need to put that on front to don't fall. And then we can use the balance, the inclination and the arms. Going back to the quality of the terrain, for example, here we pass some wet parts. It's important, for example, here to put the flat feet and do small steps so we will not glide. If it's if we put we do big steps, we will have a big gliding. So we need to look for the right places, but slippery places, it's better to do depression towards the soil. If we go in an unstable terrain like rocky, we will use more like small steps also and pushing towards the floor to don't move too much the rocks. On a trail like that it's very fast, we will look far, we will not see our feet, but we will just go forward in front because we don't really need to see exactly where we put the feet because it's kind of easy terrain. In a race, we will find a good place to accelerate and pass our colleagues. And for example, when we come to a more technical place, we will look a bit closer. You see here, we can see my feet because you need to see a bit more where you put the feet. And when it becomes a bit more easy, like we will just look in front. In the snow, we can like ski, like glide, but it's important to have our gravity center in front. So we'll put the weight of the body in front. Because if we go a bit to the back, if we have our angle like not straight, it's really easy to fall. So we will try to have our gravity center in front. And also another way to go down is like go down in the bath, like just glide down. But then it's important to have the technique to stop, so we can use our feet, or you can use ice axe or a pole to stop when we go too fast. It's really important to always be in control of the speed when we are gliding on the snow and to be able to go up wherever we want. It's important to enter the rock easy to clean the shoes from some snow and don't glide. So have a good day and enjoy the downhills!